science is kind of a different way of looking at things. And as I was reading your book, I definitely like I could relate to that in how you see things, like you start to see things differently. Do you think your book is sort of like in a way like your philosophy of life? It's not so much not just about these interesting facts about chemistry, but is it sort of a little deeper than that in terms of like your philosophy?
In a way, yes. I mean, what I talk about in the book towards the end is something that I call scientific spirit, even in German. The word spirit, we don't have a word for that in German. So when you read the original German book, you will read wissenschaftlicher Spirit, so scientific spirit. So the book is basically a love letter to chemistry from me in one way. But it's not only about chemistry, because when you fall in love with science, you might fall in love with chemistry. But you also might fall in love with astrophysics or with biology or with neuroscience, right? It doesn't even matter, right? Sometimes people try to say, "Ah, don't you? Isn't this technically physics what you're talking about? Or isn't this technically biology?" Yeah, of course. I mean, it doesn't. It's about. So in German, you would specify and say Naturwissenschaften, which means natural sciences. So anything that is evidence-based. And the beauty in that is that you can transfer this kind of thinking, this kind of evidence-based arguing to also political debates, right?
Ah, right.
And also this not only to the ability to say this is fact, let's not argue about that, but then at the same time the openness to say, well, this here we do not have scientific facts, and so we should at least tolerate different opinions without, because I feel like nowadays people treat opinions as if they were scientific facts. And then
Right.
facts, on the other hand, are somehow treated like personal opinions. And I think if you just, I don't know, learn about chemistry and about the complex ways molecules interact with each other, at first glance, it doesn't have anything to do with any politics or the way we debate with each other. But it's really finding a love for something that's complex, that's nuanced, right? Not giving in to the most obvious or easy answer, but digging deeper. This is something on a meta level that's beautiful about science, and that, yeah, that you could view as some sort of philosophy or spirit, as I called it in the book.
Right.